Hi. One of the things we're going to do for the lab is to have a bit of a registration before so that people can have access to the lab in which you can run the OpenStack over vSphere. So we'll come around and give you a bit of details. Or should we put on the link? Okay, I'll put on a link which you can see. If you can connect to that page and then please register. It's at the vmware.com/go/OpenStackLab. And I think Doug can provide you with more details.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, so if you go to this page, you should get a kind of an opening page that just kind of shows some information about how the lab environment works. And then you'll want to click on the login button in the upper right. Even if you don't have an account, then there'll be a registration link in that window. We don't use this for marketing purposes, so we won't be spamming you. It'll ask for your email address, your first name, your last name, and some security questions just to get your account created. If you have any trouble, though, let us know. And one other thing is this account will be good not just here, but all of our labs are available online for free. So once you create this account, you can use it to access any of the VMware labs. These are the labs that we deliver at the VMworld conferences. We move them into this environment so you can have access to that stuff 24/7 whenever you want. I'll pass out cards that have the generic link on it so you can get there whenever you want.
And if anybody has a question, just please raise your hand and we can come past and help you if you're having difficulty.
Hello. All right. And one other thing to mention is that we're actually going to be expanding these labs over time. So you'll see there's one fairly basic module that you can go through today, but it's kind of a generic OpenStack and vSphere environment. So if you breeze through that first module, which is kind of a step-by-step guide, normally if you go through at a normal pace, it would probably take about an hour. But once you're done with that, you can just play around with the environment and kind of do interesting things. This is right now based off of a pre-release of Havana, so it doesn't quite have everything that came in Havana, but it has the Nova and Cinder drivers for vSphere. So we're going to continuously update this lab environment over time, adding more and more kind of modules and adding new functionality that we deliver, things like putting NSX and Neutron into the lab and other things like that. So you can kind of keep an eye on this, and I think we'll later put up a lab or a link for the VMware Communities page where you can go and get updates and find out when we post new versions of the lab.
Okay. Do you need a comment? Yeah. Ah, yeah, sure. There you go.
Got everybody.
Okay, I guess we'll start now. I'm Gary from VMware. This is Doug from VMware, and James from Canonical. Basically, we're going to run through a session with a hands-on with OpenStack and vSphere, and hopefully everybody will be successful in accessing the hands-on lab, so that you can have a real experience of kind of working with a setup with OpenStack running on a vSphere backend. So, over to you, Doug.
So as I think, where would you go, Dan? Dan mentioned the lab is basically a fairly basic overview. If you're a vSphere admin, this is kind of showing you how OpenStack talks to vSphere. And if you provision an instance in OpenStack, what that looks like on the vSphere backend. If you're an OpenStack person, this kind of shows you the other side, where you know how these two things work together. It is a fairly basic lab, but it's a good 101 type lab. If you are an OpenStack person, it may help to give your vSphere admin access to this lab so they can kind of see what you're talking about. Vova is what we use to implement this. Vova is the VMware OpenStack virtual appliance. This is an appliance you can actually download from our communities page. We'll put that link up later. And you can implement it in your lab environment. But if you don't have a lab environment or you don't want to do that right now, you can just come in and take the lab pretty quick. So implementing Vova is fairly straightforward and fairly easy, but this is even quicker because we've got these labs up and running already. If you were here, this is how we get registered for the labs. If you missed that intro, raise your hand and let us know, and we'll send someone around to help get you started. Each of these labs that you get provisioned is actually a self-contained environment. We're running a nested ESX. These are the labs that we present at VMworld. So basically what we give you is two nested ESX hosts in a cluster, a shared storage appliance, and a Vova virtual machine sitting on top of it. You also have a virtual center, virtual appliance, and the control center, the button or off to the right there where it says you are here. That's a Windows box that runs DNS services. It runs Active Directory. It's basically your view into the world. These pods are completely isolated from the internet, so there is no outside or inbound traffic. All you can see is what's inside the pod. So if you want to blow it up, go ahead. If you basically do something that completely renders the lab unusable, that's okay. Just end your lab and you can register again. Usually takes 5 to 10 minutes for it to realize that your lab is gone, and then you can just click the enroll button again. So from a vSphere configuration perspective, it's a very, very simple configuration that we throw out there. One data center, one cluster, two hosts. The networking here, we use the VM network as the network for the virtual machines to connect to. The BR100 network is the private network that we use for the instances that get deployed and for the Vova appliance to talk to the instances. Vova is basically just the OpenStack components installed into a virtual machine and configured for this environment.
Hey, so let's just dig into what Vova is. So Doug's got done a little bit of detail already on that, but it's an appliance built on Ubuntu. It's available from the VMware community site. It's not supported, so this is really just for testing and proof of concept type stuff. And in terms of what's in there, it's Horizon, Nova Cinder Glance, and Keystone. So the five key components that you need to manage a vCenter vSphere deployment via OpenStack. So you're going to be able to log on to the Horizon web interface, spin up interfaces, create block devices, that sort of stuff, and plug that all together via the vSphere backend. Ubuntu OpenStack has been tested with the vSphere integration during the Havana cycle. In fact, it was one of the options in Mark's keynote on Tuesday morning, if you caught that. And we've enabled support for the VMware vSphere integration in our Juju charm. So Juju is the deployment tool for Ubuntu. So this enables you to get up and running with both OpenStack and the vSphere integration pretty quickly. If you want to do it by the standard Ubuntu OpenStack packages, that's fine as well. The key integrations are in the Nova configuration file, and it's literally four or five lines of configuration options that you're going to need to plug in there. In terms of the compute driver, the host IP of your vSphere instance, and the access credentials and the cluster name. And then very similar for Cinder in terms of the Cinder driver and then host username and password. And that should enable your OpenStack cloud to talk vSphere. OK, so I think that's pretty much all we had to cover. If you all want to crack on with the lab, we've got Gary, Doug, myself, and Dan's at the back as well. So if you have any problems, just stick your hand up, and we'll come and help you out.
Just if you have connectivity issues, just try and refresh, and then hopefully that will sort out. If not, then just please raise your hand, and we'll try and hopefully deal with it.
Yeah, unfortunately, we don't have dedicated bandwidth for this room, so we're sharing with all the rest of the conference. If you are unable to take the lab for some reason, you can still take it from home. Unfortunately, you won't have the benefit of us around to help you with that. Right, I was actually going to get there. So from a browser perspective, we do support Windows and Macs, and we support Chrome and Firefox browsers and Safari on a Mac. Internet Explorer does not support the WebSockets connection we use for the console. So we're working on that, but it's something that we don't have support for today.
Doug, can you put on the link for the... Can you put the link on, please?
Sure, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm looking at that. Yeah, I had the frowny face and I refreshed and it came back in. Okay. Now is it a browser refresh or the? Let me try something here.
If anybody does kind of get a bit lost in which lab to take, it's number 1320.
And my machine doesn't want to throw the video. My machine doesn't want to send the video to the screen. So.
Three people where that button is so fast.
That's what I was trying to, yeah. Yeah, once you get into the lab, I'm trying to show it on the screen, but once you get into the lab, there's a tab to the right in the upper right corner that says manual. If you click that, the window slides out with the lab manual in it. Once I get my screen up, I'll.
Kind of basically, once you've got the lab manual open, there are a series of steps which lead you through kind of all the stages that you can go through to the configuration, the deployment of virtual machines, kind of the attachment and detachment of Cinder volumes. Kind of Dan did a brilliant job in setting it all up. So if you guys are lost or whatever, just pick up your hands. And if you see on the screen now, kind of Doug's given an example on the tab on the right-hand side, that if you click the manual, you'll see exactly all of the steps that you can follow through to do the lab.
So if you go to the table of contents up here, you can go down and browse to the section that goes past the introductory material. Currently, we give you about 2 hours to mess around in the lab. We're looking at bumping that to 3. Probably happen in the next week or so. Yeah, so one thing that was brought up is if you have a keyboard that's a non-US keyboard, you may have issues trying to type some of the passwords or some of the inputs into the environment. We have a text file on the desktop called copy-paste. You can basically copy those text strings out and paste them into the dialog boxes. Unfortunately, that's the only workaround we've had so far that that seems to work reliably.
Well, everybody, thank you very much. If you want to carry on using the labs, it will continue to work for, I think, till your lab session ends. And if you want to do it at another time to continue, then feel free. So thank you very much, and hopefully you've enjoyed it.